Welcome to my YouTube channels. In this video, I am going to teach you a Spring Boot with Oracle Database, create one microservices. So basically, so many students, yeah, so many people are confused like how to create microservices with a Spring Boot plus Oracle Database. So it's very simple. I am going to explain everything in this video. So for this one microservices I am going to use in this video, in this project we can say JPA for connecting the Spring Boot with Oracle Database, and IDE I am going to use Eclipse. You can use STS or IntelliJ, anything. Okay, one more things, I am going to use Spring Boot, you know already. Through the Spring Boot we are going to create, and Oracle Database you already know, and create a microservices. So microservices is one of the services. It will provide something like features to communicate your front end to the back end. So it is one of the interface and you can communicate directly, so it will possible. And whatever API we can say API, or we can say microservices. So I am going to test this microservices with postman. So postman is very easy to test your API, it's working or not. Okay, so I am going to cover in this video everything, so let's join with me and do it. Okay, so first of all I am going to create one project. Simply click on the file, go to new. And you want a Spring Boot project, so just don't create Maven project, don't create any other project, just create a Spring Starter project. So this is the Spring Boot project, and here you have to enter project name. What is the project name? So you can say a Spring Boot microservices. Services with Oracle, with Oracles. Okay, I'm going to use Maven, you can use Gradle also, no problem. I'm going to Java version 8, you can use 16 11, everything. Java language I am going to use, not Kotlin, not Groovy, and jar is fine. So you can here as a group, what group you are using, and artifact is same as a name of your project, and you can change also version. Description you can change, I don't want to change. And package is same thing, so you can change also package, no problem. But I just change description, a Spring Boot microservice, that's it. Just click on the next. Now we have to decide what I want. So first you want a Spring Boot, so just click a Spring Web. Then I realize ki no, I want like tools like automatic compiles. So when I save automatic compiles, so I want a Spring Boot dev tools. Okay, now you have to think ki what I want next. So for example, you want Lambak for generate a getter setter for the entity class. Okay, and then after you thought that, oh my god, I am going to use JPA. Okay, so you click on JPA. Okay, so you want to communicate with Oracle Database, so you want one driver, so Oracle driver. So this one dependency I want, so this is all are the dependency. If dependency is not showing here, you can search in the search box like Oracle driver. So Oracle driver is come. If you want to search JPA, so just write JPA, so Spring Data JPA will come. You just click here, tick, and it automatically come. I hope you understood. Okay, if you have selected all this dependency, just click next and finish it, and make sure your system is connected with internet so that your project will be created, otherwise you getting error. Okay, so all the dependency are downloaded with you can see here this place, import getting a started content is 79% right now. So once we finish 100%, my project is ready. Now my project is not ready, it's still processing something. Okay, now my project is ready 100%. Now I just change the place. Okay, and here you can see this is the our directory structure of the Spring Boot project. So this is the src file where you are writing our all the .java file, and this is the src resources. Here you can put your statics like any template like HTML file. This is the application properties where you can configure your properties. Okay. Sorry guys, khansi ho raha hai kabhi. Okay, now this is the src test. This place, this directory we can write test case for this API, this microservices. And this is the pom.xml. So just open your pom.xml and I will show you whatever dependency you added. You can see this here. So for example, you are added JPA. So JPA is here. You added web. So web is here. You added DevTools. DevTools is there. JDBC, Oracle, connection, driver, this one is also there. You are added Lambak, Lambak is also there. So I think no problem. Everything is fine. Good. Okay. If everything is good, then do one thing. What we have to do? Just click. Okay. And what you have to do? You have to configure the properties files. So I have just Right now, your JPA want some configuration like with database. If you are not provided, then if you run your application, you are getting might be error. Okay, please configure. Like I just change the port number and run your application. Port number is 8023. You can change anything. Okay, and now I'm going to run my application. It will give me some error. Why? Why? Because I have not configured Oracle database with JPA. JPA want all those configuration. If you are not provided, then it's saying error. Yeah, it's given some exception like that. The driver is not loaded. Everything is not configured. Please configure like that. Okay, so just see the console. You can see failed to configure the data source URL attribute, not specified and not embedded data source. मतलब कि कोई भी आप ना embedded use किए हो ना कोई ऐसे कोई database use नहीं किए हो तो हम क्या करें इसके लिए? Embedded database H2, HSQL, Deriby, like so many embedded databases there, so you can use. I already teach you H2 database. You can see in my video. Okay. Okay, no problem. I will configure. So just you are changing the port number. Now you have to configure your Oracle database. So you want JDBC URL and user ID and password. That's it. So you just write spring dot data source. Yeah, one more things. What I'm doing, man. This one is the port number. Okay. URI, if you write URI, you get it Spring Boot secret. Some places you can see URI Spring Boot dot data source dot URI. Sorry guys, hey, so many things is there here. You are unable to find out, so you can write also, no problem. So you just write like that. I will tell you spring dot data source dot URL. So this is the URL, yeah, URI. So this is the URL. You just, no, not this one. This one, first one you take URL, and you have to provide JDBC connection. So JDBC URL. So JDBC colon Oracle colon thin colon at the rate local host colon 1521. You can see whatever you configure with JDBC, that's it only, and XE, that's it. One more things you want password, so just copy this one, don't write too much time, just remove this one URI, just out user. So user will come. So whatever you have a user ID, so my user ID is Prince, and just paste it and remove it. Password, so just write password is also my Prince, so both are same. Okay, no problem. Okay, so this is the configuration with my Oracle database. And one more things, you have to give a permission ki what you have to do with Oracle database. JPA have some features like spring.jpa. So you can see here spring.jpa.hibernate.ddl.auto. So you click this one auto, and it will give you some features like create. So you are able to create only project. So you are able to create, if you write this one, then you can create only table, you can't insert anything. And every time your table is created, if you create like that, create and drop, then CR, then your table is created and drop, created and drop. So it is not good. So you just write create one times, for example. So it will give you like update. It means once time table is created, and then after just update data, it will update only. You don't want to, it is not going to delete your tables and again create a table. It is just updated whatever table is available. So I have provided all those information regarding the database, and this is the JPA for permission to update the data, and yeah, everything is fine now. So just do one thing, so run this one. You can see your application is running fine right now, no problem, because you are configured everything. Okay, so your application is running on. What is happening, man? Started Spring Boot microservices application. You can see here, started Spring Boot microservices system in this second with JVM running on this port numbers, and you can see which port number your application is running on. You can see this thing also, 802.23, your port number is running on your application. Okay, no problem, it is fine now. Okay, so I am able to configure my database with my project, it is fine. Now we are going to create one microservices, and this microservices want one model data, like any student data or yeah, any things you can just store in the database so that you can communicate easily. Okay, so for this one I am going to create one model class. So you have to differentiate everything in the separate packages. Okay, so now I'm going to create one class with different packages, model packages. So just click com.app.model and give the name like a student. Maybe a student table is available. Okay, no problem right now. A student. So one package is created, com.app.models, and this is the base package. You have to click after that, you can add only package name. So student.java package is created. Now I want to add, And now I want to insert some data. So just write private, you want one ID. So just take long ID, and this one is the ID, and you want to generate this ID. Okay, one more things, private string name. Okay, private string address, that's it. And I want to generate ID like dynamically. I don't want to give ID, it's generated automatically. So you just write here ID. Little bit my system is slow, no problem, it will take care of everything. Okay, persistence you have to import, and one more things you have to add, like generated value. So generated value and strategy equal to auto. Just write auto and control and shift, so you get it auto. Hatto, everything is fine. Okay, good. And maybe you want to change, you don't want to create a getter setter. So you just, I have used lambac @data. It will give you setter, getter, equals, everything methods. You want constructors, so all are constructors. I think you don't want this one also, but you can take it. Just remove this one, data, and you have to write this one is a entity class. So just write entity, this one is a entity, and you give model class. So you make it, so this JPA is what JPA believe, like this is the entity class, and I have to insert this object in hubahub in database. So it's a automatically mapping will performs. You want to change the table name, so you just write table tag for change the table name. If you are not right, if you write like that, so your table name is a student, a small student. Now you can change your table name also here. So you just write name equal to, and whatever you given like a student table. So this is the table name, student table. Okay, and everything is fine now. Okay, so my model class is ready. I want one repository, it means JPA repository. So JPA will do operation like save operation, delete operation, update operation, select operation. So one more class interface I want. So I just click here interface. So this one is interface. Interface, I have a store repository, and name is student repo. That's it. Just create it. This interface extend, yeah, implement extend, because JPA repository is also a interface. So just write JPA repository. In first column, yeah, you can say first parameter, you have to send whatever entity class you have. So right now I have a entity class like student. So just write here student, and just import this one, and second you have a one class like student, one class, what is the ID, whatever ID you provided. So ID is long type, so just write long, everything file. Okay, where is my camera? My camera is this place only. Okay, no problem. So adjust your camera. Okay, good. So my repository is also ready, my string data is also ready now. So I have structured everything, like model class is model package, repo class is repository package, controller class is control package. So now I have to create one controller for microservices. So I'm going to create one class and with one package. So this package name is controller, TROLLER. So controllers, and this class name is student controllers. You can write, this is the naming convention. So CONTROLLER controllers, so student controllers. Here you have to write one microservices. So for example, if you want to make this class as a REST like Spring Boot microservices, so you have to write one annotation called REST controller. So this is the controllers. If you write, it will become the REST controllers like its behave. Okay, and this is the one of the microservices. And in this microservices, I am going to write one method, one microservices for insert the data in database. So this is the one of the microservice. So service is store the data in database. So I am going to provide one microservices for store the data in database with Spring Boot with Oracle. So simply I am going to create one public response entity. Response entity is one of the class. It will give you a response like data with HTTP status. Okay, so you have to prefer this one. I am going to write a string and save a student data. You can say student service is a method. It is one of the microservices. And this microservices, yani ki this method or this services take one parameter as a object. So request, request body having a one object, and object type is a student. So you just write a student s. Okay, now you have to return something. So I have just returned null. Now your error is fine. Don't get any error. Okay, what you have to do next, you have to map. For example, anyone call this microservices, so it will give you some URL. So you have to map this URL with endpoint. You are saying endpoint. So you have to write get a post mapping. If you are inserting the data, if you are taking data, so you have to write post mapping, get mapping. You have to learn about it. When you have to take get mapping, when you have to take post mapping, when you have to take delete mapping, when you have to take put mapping. So simply when you want to receive the data from the end users and save this data in database, so you have to take post mapping. So I have take post mapping, and just I have written save. So save is a end URL, yeah, end point you can say, and for this microservices, and you are going to save this data in the database. So what I have to do, so I have everyone hit this URL, so those peoples are getting one response like I will send something like new response entity. Right now I will send response entity with a string, and a string having two things, good and comma HTTP status dot okay. The 200 will be gone. So for example, this is already running on. So for example, you just remove it, because right now you are not going to send anything. If you send, it's not a problem. So right now your data is not going to store in database, but it is running on. Okay, so you want to test this one, just write postman, open your postman, and I am going to hit this microservices. This is one of the microservices, and this responsibility is to store the data in database. Okay, so right now I have not written anything for the store the data in database, but everything is ready. I just test this microservices is hitting or not. Okay, so when our postman is open, I just write two things, I just auto add at the rate auto add for creating the object for the repository private student repo. So I want a student repo or repo. That's it. So automatically this one a student repo object is created here, and you can provide the operations whatever JPA repository having. So JPA repository having so many methods, you can update, remove, insert, find all, everything is there. So you can perform the operation here. So I have created the object of this student repo, and this is the subclass of the student JPA repository. So this object is created. Now I have to save. Okay, do one thing. So this one is fine, I think. So this one is the test. So go on the test and write okay, test, open your test. And this is the HTTP colon localhost, my port number is H023. Now I have to change this one, endpoint. Endpoint is save. So just click on save. And you have to send data, not a phone number. You have to send two things. One is name. So name is, for example, Prince, and comma address. Address is like Hyderabad. That's it. So this object I have to send, and I have to send this object in this localhost, and save is the endpoint. So you can see here, save is the endpoint I am going to call, and send the data in a student object, and through this annotation we can receive. And I am going to do one more things, s out, and just print s dot to a string. So data will be printed also in console. So right now everything is fine. So just hit. Oh my god. So you get it message like a string format. It is a good, and your status is 200 and okay. And your database is, your data is printed in console also. This one, SID is 0, and name is Prince, and address is Hyderabad. Oh my god, good. Okay, so it's happened, and you can hit the URL. So just you want to do one things for store this data in database. What you have to do, you have already created the repo, so you have already data. So just remove this one. Yeah, you can put also, no problem. You have to call repo. So repo dot save. Save is a method to save the object in this class. Okay, save the object in the database. This repo is connected with the database because of the configuration file. So just create a student object here. So new. Yeah, you can say like new student. And new student having two things. One is, I think you don't want this one here. You do another things. Like you just create the object for the student. So student s1 equal to new student. Okay. So object is created. Now you have to set this data in this object. So s1 dot set name, and name is whatever you got it, set name. So s1 dot get name, not get address, s1 dot get name. What you are doing here, you are creating one object of the student class, and you are reading the data from the s, whatever data is coming from the postman in this s. So you are getting data from the S and you are setting this S1. Is it fine? Is it fine or is it not fine? Okay, is it fine? Okay, if is it fine, you can do like that. Otherwise, you can set like that only. Repo dot save of S. This one object you can save directly. So this one object you can save directly, no problem. That's it. So once you save this one, automatically, because of dev tools, automatically your project is running. And just one, you can hit this one URL. So data is sent it and good. You get it, the response is good and 200. If you want to see in Oracle database, so you can just open SQL and just connect with SQL. So connect, username is Prince, password is Prince, no problem. You can listen also, no problem, my password. And just write select star from student table, because I have changed the name of the table. So you can get it address ID. So ID is 30 and Hyderabad and Prince. So you get it, no problem. Okay, one more record if you want to save, you just say Deepak and North Hyderabad Motihari. Just send it, good. And one more time, so just click, so you get it response like that. 30 Hyderabad Prince, 31 Motihari Deepak, like that. You get it response like that. So I hope you got it, ki how you can save the data, and you have to send this data in JSON format. You have to remember it. And if you want to see what is the table name, so table is this one. I have changed table name also. So everything is fine. And whatever I am saying, so this one is the one of the microservices for save the student record in the database. So this is one of the microservices. You can you in real time, if you are doing this one, so every services in the separate controllers. So one service in one controllers, another service in another controllers, you have to write like that. Okay, now this one is fine. In real time, what you are doing, you just receive the data of the student. You have to verify it, this data is correct or not. If it is correct, then insert it. If you are getting any error, you have to throw the errors. So many operations will be performed in real time, but now this is the good. And if you learn how to communicate with the database, this is the fine. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you want more video on this topic, so you can just comment it and just give me feedback how you connected with this video and how you are doing the work for this. Okay, thank you so much for watching my video. Once again, bye. Please subscribe my channels, don't forget it.